Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with a completely new product. Tonic Studios will be releasing one die set every month. Now this is not a subscriber's kit, it is called Designer's Choice. So on the day of the release you can see the product, you can watch many videos with a lot of inspiration from many designers, and if you like it, you can grab it. But just remember, this is exclusive to the Tonic stores, online stores, and it is limited stock, so if you like it, you need to move fast. So let's take a close-up look on what you get for October. Now these dies are actually made to create an easel card. I'm going to show you how you can put this together, but I'm also going to share more simple cards, which is actually my style. Now you can see this border is beautiful and it fits inside that die, but of course you can use it separately, and I think this would make a great flap for cards with beautiful lace designs. You also get a die of a dragonfly in a beautiful detailed design that fits inside that border as well, so you can use them together or separately. And also you get many butterflies as well as flowers and a couple of sentiments. Today I'm going to share 4 cards using products from this kit, but first let's take a look on how you can put together the easel card. So I'm going to make a card with a big contrast with purple and white so you can see exactly what I'm doing. First of all, I'm going to score on the fold lines. So I have first cut out of white cardstock the big basic dies, and you will be able to put those together later on. So first I'm going to use some double-sided tape and I'm going to add that only on the flap. And this is the only place you need to glue those pieces together. And you will see at the end this is going to allow for some movement. Now I have cut out the lovely border, and I don't know if you can see, but some of the designs are cut out in such a way so that you can lift them up and add dimension. And that's on some of the flowers as well as on the butterflies. So I'm adding some dimension by lifting up the petals as well as the wings. And now I can add some glue at the back, and for that I'm using my Nuvo Deluxe glue and stick it in place. You will see that it fits nicely on top of the base and it leaves a lovely border all around. This is going to be the base of my easel card, but you can see how beautiful it looks, and it would work great as a flap on a gatefold card, and I absolutely love that lace look that it gives. Now on the back of my dragonfly I'm going to add some glue again and stick it on the other white piece that I have cut out, and you will see again it's going to fit nicely and leave a white border all around. And now it's time to put those pieces together so you can see how the mechanism works. Now it's super easy to do, just peel off the backing from the flap and then place that on the fold. Like so, and you will notice that the edges match perfectly, so it is really easy to align it on top. Press where the glue is, and your easel card is ready. So this can stand up like so. The top flap can be tucked underneath those wings of the butterflies and stand still, or you can just press it and put it inside the envelope completely flat. Now I'm going to complete my card by adding a sentiment. I used one of the dies from the set as well. I am going to stick that on the inside just underneath the flap. So in order to reveal the sentiment, you need to open up the card completely. Of course, that's the area where you can write your message. Now you can call this card done or take it a step further like I'm doing here. So I'm going to stick the whole easel card on top of a glitter cardstock that's 4.25 by 5.5, and now I have an easel card in standard dimensions. And now this is what you do when you don't know when to stop. So I have cut out the dragonfly one more time, and I'm going to use some bits and pieces from this die cut and stick them on my main dragonfly. And here is another idea on how you can use this die. You can cut out the dragonfly out of different colored cardstocks and then fill in all the different gaps with different bits and pieces. And you can see how I work really quickly with that thing. So it's not really that time consuming as you think. To complete my card and to use pretty much every die on the kit, I'm also going to use this sentiment. Again, it's from the kit, and I combined white cardstock with glitter cardstock. I'm going to stick one on top of the other, and this is going to go on top of my dragonfly. I also added a few nouveau drops, and here is how my complete card looks. And remember that you can put this flap down and flatten it up completely so it fits inside an envelope. It is a card that it is really easy to put together, and I hope the color choices that I did with white and contrasting purple was helpful so you could see exactly what I was doing. And now I'm going to share three more cards in a more clear and simple way so you can see that bits and pieces from this club kit can be used for many different styles. I'm going to cut out the dragonfly out of this white cardstock. I'm going to use the negative for this card and the actual dragonfly for the next card, so I'm not throwing it away. And you can easily turn this design into a shaker card if you want. However, I'm going to just ink up the back, and for that I'm using Distress Oxide ink. I'm using one of my favorite color combinations, and that's Worn Lipstick and Spiced Marmalade. I'm also going to add some water splashes, let them react with the ink for a few seconds, and then blot them. I love this look since I think that all those splashes add more interest on my background, but if you don't like splashes, you can leave it as it was. Now I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and stick that on top of my card base. And I'm going to stick the Just For You sentiment. Now of course for that you can cut out a border to place at the back. I decided for this card to leave it as it is, so I'm just going to stick it on top. As a finishing touch, I'm adding some nouveau drops in different areas of the card, and here are some close-up photos. For the next card, I'm going to use the dragonfly that I cut out for the previous card, and again I'm going to use Distress Oxide ink to do a background. Again, here I'm using one of my favorite color combinations, which is cracked pistachio and peacock feathers. Once I cover up completely the whole base, I'm going to add some water splashes again, just like I did with the previous background, blot them, and my background is ready to just stick on top my dragonfly. This is a very simple and quick design, and for your background you can use any pattern paper that you probably have at home. I think that the focal point really makes the card. It is super gorgeous and really unique. Also notice that I added glue only at the center of the dragonfly, at the actual body, so that I can lift the wings and add some dimension. And I'm going to finish it off by sticking down one of the sentiments. I cut this out of white cardstock and I colored it with a black marker. Now I have some double-sided tape at the back, which I am going to peel off and stick it down. This way I have double-sided tape inside those letter gaps. And this is where I'm going to stick back the letters, which are white. And I absolutely love this effect. You will be able to see that on the close-up photos. You can use those sentiments with many different ways, without the border, with the border, just the letters, or stick inside the gaps different colored letters. Really versatile. Now for the last card, I'm going to create my own stencil. For that I'm using just an acetate from an old packaging. I'm going to use two circles in different sizes so that I can cut out, and now I can use that stencil to create a few circles on my background. For that again I'm going to use my blending tools and the colors that I used for the previous card, since I had those blending tools on my table. Now this way I created some areas where I can stick on top butterflies. I have these butterflies from the kit in different sizes and designs that I have cut out from white cardstock. And before I stick them down, I decided here to add some more splashes for interest on my card. You know I love splashes, but really you don't need to do that if you don't like this look. And then finally I can stick the butterflies on top. Again, for that I'm adding only at the body some glue at the back, so that I can lift the wings and add dimension. Although, of course, these are going to flatten up if you're going to send this through the mail, but if you're going to hand it out for a birthday or something else, then they are going to be dimensional. For the sentiment, I'm going to repeat the same look as I did for the previous card. So I cut out just for you with a black cardstock, and then on the inside I'm going to add all the letters in white. I also created a card base that's 4.25 by 5.5, where I'm going to stick on top this panel, and of course you can use any color that matches the colors of the circles. Here are some close-up photos on this card. And let's take a quick look on all the four cards that I made for today, both the simple looking ones as well as the easel card in a more complicated look. So I hope this video was helpful and gave you some ideas on how you can use the October Designer's Choice die set by Tonic Studios. You will find links and everything you need down below in the description area, as well as a discount code. So I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for visiting today, and I'll see you all next time.